So in today's video we are going to discuss about the numericals of electricity chapter. Okay, so first question: calculate the number of electrons constituting 1 coulomb of charge. How many number of electrons? Calculate the number of electrons. See, while you are getting a numerical question, first you should read the question properly. Okay? And what and all are given in datas are given in the question. Write down that. What we should find out, that one with a symbol, put a question mark. The given data and the thing which we need to find out, what is the relation? You identify the relation, substitute and find out the answer. So solving numericals, it's easy actually, but while numericals or problem solving, it will be a difficult problem, like that all the children will be thinking. Actually it is very easy task if you know the formula and the concept thoroughly. So that's why I am telling you, don't try to by heart. Understand the concept, then by heart. By hearting is required. Actually by hearting for some this heating effect and all we learn, right? So all those things, applications and all, by hearting is required. But if we know the concept, that by hearting will be very easy. Okay, so here coming back to the portion, calculate the number of electrons, number n, constituting 1 coulomb of charge. 1 coulomb of charge means what is this? Charge representation is Q, 1 coulomb. So only this much is there. We need to find out n. How we can find out n? Tell me, what is the relation connecting Q and N? Q equals NE. So while we are substituting, what we will get? Q equals NE. So 1 equals N, we don't know. E is, what is E? Charge of electron. What is the charge of electron? 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So N equals 1 by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So you will get the answer as 1 by 1.6. That is 0.625 into 10 to the power 19. That means 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 electrons will be there. Okay, so till here if you are doing, that means you understood the things. Okay, next is calculation. That one you should know the mathematics, then only you can solve it, isn't it? So Q equals N into E, N we should find out, 1 by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So what is 1 by 1.6? 6.625 we got. This as by calculation you will get. Okay, you see we can't by heart all the formulas like this, isn't it? So you can do it. Do the calculation, 10 by 16 and then 5 by 8, you can calculate. Okay, so the next question is, a current of 16 ampere flows in a metallic wire for 60 minutes. Find net charge passed in this duration. So see the question, current of 16 ampere, current means I, equals 16 ampere, 60 minutes. So time is given as 60 minutes. Minutes is not an SI unit, isn't it? So we should convert this, that into SI unit. 60 into 60, that is 3600 seconds. So what we should find, net charge passing through the circuit. Charge means Q. We should find out. What is the relation connecting I, T and Q? Yes, I equals Q by T. See this equation. I is equal to Q by T. So what is Q here? I into T. I is 16 ampere into 3600. So 16 into 36 is 576, you will get, so that is 0 coulomb. So understood? This is very easy and you can easily solve this. Okay. So next one is, a wire of uniform area of cross section is stretched to 6 by 5 times its original length. By what factor does its resistance and resistivity change? So here change is happening for length. Okay, a wire, I have a wire. I'm stretching the wire and changing its length to 6 by 5 of its original length. Okay, so L, if L is the original length and A is the area of cross section, how we can find out this resistance? R equals rho into L by A. This is the formula, isn't it? L and A is given. So R equals rho into L by A. Here I have a wire. I am stretching the wire. So you know that Play-Doh. I am making it into one, it's a 10 centimeter length. Okay. If I want to increase the length, what I should do? Again, I will decrease the area of cross section and will increase the length. Isn't it? While we are making chapati dough also, we will do the same thing. Isn't it? If we have a little bit dough with us and we want to increase the number, what we will do? We will decrease the area. Isn't it? So, but the total volume remains the same. Okay? So, here we are in stretching and increasing the length. Okay? So, how is the new length? This is the new length. New length, I am writing it as L dash. Stretching into 6 by 5 times of the original length. Original length is L. New length is 6 by 5 times the original length. Then, obviously, area will decrease, isn't it? So, what will be the new area? How we can find out the area? Okay, area, actually if the length is, how we will find out is, the volume remains the same, isn't it? See, if 500 grams or 100 grams of dough is there, means if we are increasing the length or increasing the area, decreasing the area, volume remains 100 gram only, isn't it? So, here as length increases, area will decrease. That's what happening. Volume remains the same, isn't it? So if it is length is increasing by 6 by 5, area will be 5 by 6 times the original area. It will become just ulta. How is it happening is, we are multiplying with the, we are equating the volumes. Okay, while we are equating the A into L, V equals A dash into L dash. So what is A into L equals A dash into 5 by 6 L. Sorry, 6 by 5 L. Okay. So L and L will get cancelled. 5A by 6 will be A dash. This is what happening. So you just remember, like, if you are difficult to understand this thing. It's not difficult actually. Area into length is volume. Okay. This is the original volume. Now this is the increased volume. Both will be same. We are not adding anything to it. Isn't it? So, area into length equals A dash into, what is the new length? 6 by 5, L. So, it will become 5 by 6. Okay. So, 5 by 6 of the new area. Okay. Now, so what is the resistance here? R dash equals rho into L dash. What is the resistivity of the new conductor? Resistivity depends on the substance. It won't vary with length or area. So, resistivity will remain the same. So, already we are getting one answer for this. How the resistivity will change? Resistivity will remain the same. It won't vary with the length or area. Okay. So, resistivity will be R dash equals rho into L dash divided by A dash. Okay. Now, so, we are comparing, isn't it? So, R dash divided by R equals. How we can? So, dividing these two equations. This is equation 1 and this is equation 2. Equation 2 divided by 1, while we are doing, we will get it as rho into L dash divided by A dash divided by rho into L by A. Rho and rho will get cancelled. What is L dash? 6 by 5 L divided by. What is A dash? Is 5 by 6 A. So equation 2 divided by 1 equals R dash divided by R equals rho into, here we can substitute for L dash. So here while we are substituting the L dash and A dash values, R dash equals rho into, what is L dash? 6 by 5 L divided by A dash. So in A dash it is the fraction. So what we should do in the denominator? We should take the reciprocal and multiply. So 6 by 5 divided by, so A dash equals 5 by 6 A. So 5 by 6 A means 6 by 5 A. So 6 into 6 is rho into L by A. That one I am taking it outside. And so it will be 36 divided by 25. That is, what is this rho into L by A? Rho into L by A is the old R, isn't it? So 36 divided by 25. So the new resistance will be 36 divided by 25 times the old resistance. So clear now? So here, how the resistance and resistivity will be changing. Resistance formula we know, rho into L by A. The new resistive length is 6 by 5 of length. If the length is stretching to 6 by 5, then area will be, become 5 by 6 of original area. So how we are getting this one? By calculating the volume. Otherwise at least this much you should understand. So volume remains the same, area into length will be equal. So A dash L dash equals A into L. So you are getting 5 by 6 of area. So this one you should understand. Okay, L dash equals 6 by 5 of L, A dash equals 5 by 6 of A. R dash, rho, rho won't change with respect to length or area. So R dash equals rho into L dash divided by A dash. So here substituting for L dash, 6 by 5 L, and substituting for A dash divided by A dash. So it is coming in the denominator. Denominator, it is a fraction. So we are taking the reciprocal and multiplying. While taking the reciprocal, it will be 6 by 5 A. 6 by 5 A. So 6, 6 are 36, 5, 5 are 25. So rho L by A. What is this rho L by A? That is old resistance. So new resistance will be equal to 36 divided by 25 times the old resistance. Clear now how we are doing this thing? Okay. Next is fourth question. Draw a schematic diagram of a circuit consisting of battery of two cells, each of 1.5 volt, 5 ohm resistor, 10 ohm resistor and 15 ohm resistor and a plug key, all connected in series. Okay, so we have two cells first. Positive, negative, and another cell is positive, negative. Each one is 1.5. So this is 1.5 volt. This also 1.5 volt. One positive, one negative. Then next is one positive, one negative. So it became a battery consisting of two cells. Each one is 1.5 volt. Okay. And a 5 ohm resistor. Next, everything is series. So first one is one resistor 5 ohm, another resistor 10 ohm, another resistor 50 ohm, and a plug key. So we bond means we can do it series like that. So it will be very lengthy circuit. So better than that, we can do it like this. And a plug key, and this all like that. I'm showing you. Okay, is connected in series. So it should be a closed circuit. So for all these representations, you should mark. Okay, 1.5, 1.5, then 5 ohm, 10 ohm, 15 ohm, and this is plug key. Okay, from positive to negative, current will be flowing. Okay, this is the representation. This is how whatever is telling in the question, same way you should draw. If a voltmeter is connecting in parallel, if they are saying, so to which resistor and a 10 ohm and a voltmeter is connected in parallel with a 10 ohm resistor. Like that, if in the question if it is given, means you can connect one voltmeter also. Okay, parallel. So in this question it is not given. So if it is given like that, you can. Okay, because voltmeter will always be connected in parallel with the circuit. Okay, clear now? Okay. So this much, this many numericals, all of you got it right. So the next videos we will be showing how to do the rest of the numericals. Okay. Thank you.